We have seen that a covalent bond consists of two electrons, one from each bonding atom. Electrons and valence orbitals take part in bond formation. Valence orbitals with single electrons overlap to make a bond with a pair of electrons. The overlap is the bond between the atoms. A bond is the maximum overlap of two atomic or valence orbitals. The electrons in a bond have opposite spins. We looked at the five basic types of hybrid atomic orbitals: sp, sp2, sp3, sp3d, and sp3d2. The number of hybrid orbitals is the same as the number of contributing atomic orbitals. Each type of hybrid orbital has its characteristic geometry. SP hybridized valence orbitals have linear geometry, such as for the beryllium atom and beryllium fluoride. SP2 hybridized valence orbitals are arranged trigonally, as for the boron atom in boron trifluoride. Valence orbitals that are sp3 hybridized form a tetrahedron, as in the carbon atom of methane. Valence orbitals that are sp3d hybridized are arranged in a trigonal bipyramid, as in the phosphorus atom in phosphorus pentachloride. For sp3d2 hybridized atomic orbitals, the arrangement is octahedral, as in the sulfur atom in sulfur hexafluoride. A sigma bond is the most common type of bond. Sigma bonds are present in single, double, and triple bonds. A single bond is always a sigma bond. Sigma bonds are formed by overlap of electrons from s, p, or any hybrid orbitals. The electron density for a sigma bond is highest along the bond axis. If we look at this bond down its axis, it looks like a sphere. If a second bond is to be made between two atoms already bonded, it will be made by overlap of p orbitals. A good example is ethylene, which has five sigma bonds all in one plane. The second bond between the carbon atoms in ethylene is the overlap of the pz orbitals. A second bond is a pi bond. The electron density for a pi bond is highest on either side of the bond axis. If we look at the pi bond from the side of the bond axis, we can see that it is above and below the plane of the atoms in ethylene. Finally, we saw that atoms that are joined by just a sigma bond are able to freely rotate about the bond, such as the two carbons in ethane. If two or more bonds are present, free rotation is not possible. Rotation about a double bond, such as the carbon-carbon bond in ethylene, will not happen unless the pi bond is first broken. The pi bond thus prevents the bond rotation between two atoms that are multiply bonded.